Kedar Patil. I am a bariatric advanced laparoscopy and gastrointestinal oncosurgeon practicing in Pune. Well, people do ask what is an ideal weight and what is obesity. So, to have a simple equation or to understand it in more simple ways, if you calculate your height in centimeters and deduct 100 out of it, would be an ideal weight. So, a person who is 150 centimeters in height, if you deduct 100 from it, 50 would be an ideal weight for this person. So anything above that is termed as excess weight. It is important to understand that obesity is a disease. Just as one understands that hypertension is a disease, diabetes is a disease, having cardiac problems or kidney problems is a disease, just like that, obesity is a disease. And it is a root cause of many of the problems. WHO has classified obesity as BMI about 27.5. The criteria for Asians are different than rest of the world because Asians are more prone for central obesity, type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular diseases. Anybody having a waist circumference above 90 centimeters for males or 80 centimeters for females is termed to be obese. Or having obesity. And being obese puts a person at risk of having diabetes by 22 times than compared to a normal person. Also, person is at risk of developing endometrial, breast, colonic and pancreatic cancers later in life. Person who has a BMI above 32.5 with any of the diseases that I mentioned earlier, be it diabetes, hypertension, joint pain, sleep apnea, infertility, should definitely seek an obesity consultant to solve the problem of obesity. Anybody with a BMI of 27.5 and above, whose disease is not getting controlled with the regular medications of diabetes, hypertension, or with the other non-surgical methods, should again seek an expert opinion by an obesity consultant. Well, speaking about bariatric surgery, people often ask this question, why and how is bariatric and metabolic surgery done? Well, bariatric surgery in simple language is weight loss surgery, and when we speak about metabolic surgery, it means that we are looking at curing the diseases which are associated with obesity. Obesity, broadly speaking, is associated with almost 20 to 25 different diseases. The most common diseases being diabetes, hypertension, hyperlipidemia, joint pains, infertility, snoring. So there are a lot of issues that come with obesity, and it's just not a state, it's a disease that is very important to understand. So people ask why bariatric surgery is done first of all. Well, if you see, diet and doing a right exercise can produce weight loss, but it has its own limitations. The reason being, when a person tries to reduce down his intake and do more exercise, he feels more hungry. The reason is the stomach portion here. This part, the fundic area, produces a hormone known as ghrelin, which stimulates appetite. So what happens is a person starts eating more when he is exercising, but at some point of time the exercise stops. Once the exercise stops, the stimulated ghrelin remains at a higher level and person continues to eat more. Thereby he regains the lost weight. So this keeps on happening in a circle where person loses weight, regains weight, loses weight, regains weight. There is an weight loss that is seen up to 10% of the total weight of the body, which is maximum possible with a diet and exercise regime. If a person's BMI is more than 32.5, he cannot lose that target weight to achieve a good, healthier life. In that case, we recommend bariatric surgery. Bariatric surgery, on the contrary to diet and exercise, can make you lose up to 60 to 80% of the excess weight. So there's a huge difference between a 10% weight loss and a 60 to 80% weight loss. So it is indicated for the right persons who have a BMI above 32.5 and those who cannot lose weight with a diet and exercise regime. The difference between a liposuction and bariatric surgery is, in liposuction, the fat, superficial fat on the body is removed. So the subcutaneous fat over the belly, the arms or buttocks or breasts would be removed. So on the contrary, in bariatric surgery, what we are doing is, we are doing surgeries on the intestine so that there is a hormonal change that happens in the body. Liposuction, at one setting, the maximum 5 to 6 liters of fat is removed, which doesn't translate into 5 to 6 kgs. So a person who is excess by 50 or 60 kgs or even by 20 kgs would require multiple settings of a liposuction. In liposuction, again, there can be weight regain because the GI pathology is unaltered. In bariatric surgery, on the contrary, what we are doing is, we are altering the gastrointestinal tract in such a way that person continues to lose weight in spite of eating. And the best part is, bariatric surgery can take down the weight to a significant lower level. About 60 to 80% of excess weight is lost. The diet and exercise modifications, lifestyle changes are taught to a patient in multiple reviews and with the doctor and the team, where the change in the diet, exercise and lifestyle has to be maintained after surgery, thereby the weight regain is prevented. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel if you like it, and do contact us if you need some more information. Thank you again.